kitchen and it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it.
What's up, guys? Welcome to my show, Mad Stuff with Rob. I am Rob and I'm back with another episode. And in this episode, we are going to do a room decor idea. I'm going to make a wood sign. Now, I've seen a lot of variations of these on the internet and I wanted to make one for my studio. So, I'm going to share the technique with you guys. So, get ready. It's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. To make this wood sign, you need to grab few items. Here's your list. All right, let's get started. So to make a wood sign, you need a piece of wood. I have one right here. The dimensions of this wood piece is 3 feet by 4 inches. Now, what you can do is, you can cut the sides to make this piece a little more interesting. Cool, so we got these pieces out, we don't need it. Now we're going to paint our wood, and to paint, you can either use watercolors or really watery acrylic colors. We are going to darken our wood piece here. Don't worry about the application. We are not trying to get perfect strokes here. We are just trying to darken the wood. So if your strokes are uneven, it will just add to the distressed look. Okay, we are done with the painting. Now I'm going to put this wood piece on the side for drying. Now we need to add text to our wood sign. So you can think of an interesting quote or a saying, or something small that you can add to the wood sign. So here I have a strip of box board and you can see I have cut it to size. Place the printouts and align it so that the coat is complete. Okay, so let's apply some glue and stick it. Okay, so the sticking is done. We move to cutting. I'm going to just follow the lines of the text here, and very easily I can cut a stencil out. So the cutting is done and our stencil is ready. We need to get the wood piece in and then transfer this coat onto our wood piece or our wood sign. I'm going to use some sticky tape so that it doesn't move. Now it's time to paint. I'm using acrylic colors again. And I'm using a sponge instead of a brush. And I'm going to just dab the paint. And because of the sponge, I'll get a nice texture, which will look great. Okay, we are done with the coloring. So I'm using a cutter to cut the tape. I can easily remove the stencil. There you go. With that, our sign is ready. Okay, now I'll show you how you can hang this. So I'm using these eye hooks. You can see they have a loop on top and a screw at the bottom. So now we'll make a hole in the piece of wood. When you're using hammer and pliers, guys, be very careful. Don't hurt yourself. Okay, this one is done. Let's fix the other one. So I'm repeating the same process. Okay, we are done with the eye hooks. Now I'm using this coir thread or rope. Pass it through the eye hook and then tie a knot or two. And then you can cut the extra bit. Now I'm gonna leave a couple of feet and do the same thing for the other side. And there you go, our wood sign is ready with my favorite coat. All you need is love. I think the wood sign turned out really nice. It looks really rustic, very vintagey, if that's a word. I think it looks cool. And it's nice to have these kind of sayings and quotes in your room because it adds a lot to your room. Also, it motivates you when you look at it every day, brings a smile to your face and reminds you, like this quote reminds me that all I need is love. And I get love every day from you guys because you like my videos, you share it with your friends. So in the comment section below, let me know what are your favorite quotes or your favorite saying, things that you like to hear and see every day. Also, if you are trying this, then click pictures and share them with me. You know how to get in touch with me. I'm on Instagram, I'm on Snapchat, Facebook, and plus right here on YouTube, making cool DIY videos for you guys. All right, I'll see you next time. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.